after Trump saved UCLA player, Ungrateful father just brutally stabbed Trump in the back. No matter what he does and how much he wins, President Trump just can't seem to make the left happy. Even when he gets three spoiled entitled ball players out of hot water in China. President Trump is able to save and get three UCLA basketball players safely home. LiAngelo Ball, Cody Riley, and Jalen Hill, who have now been suspended indefinitely by the Bruins basketball team. All three players apologized at a news conference Wednesday morning about the incident in China that had them stay behind on a team trip after they were accused of shoplifting at three different local area stores. But of course, since their messiah, former President Barack Hussein Obama, had no hand in freeing these three characters, the American left and even one of the players' father just can't seem to give Trump the credit he so rightly deserves. In fact, LaVar Ball, LiAngelo's father, is not giving President Trump any of the credit. When asked about his son's return and the whole ordeal, he actually had the galls to say who. When asked about Trump's involvement in the matter, what was he over there for? Don't tell me nothing. Everybody wants to make it seem like he helped me out. Grammar is key. Trump scolds LiAngelo Ball, are you going to thank me? The three UCLA players who were detained in China for shoplifting returned to the U.S. on Tuesday night, following intervention from, among others, President Donald Trump. As immensely relieved as LiAngelo Ball, Jalen Hill and Cody Riley must be to have been allowed to leave so quickly, not to mention to have avoided prison sentences, they came back to calls for strong punishments from the school, and a chiding from the president. Do you think the three UCLA basketball players will say thank you, President Trump? They were headed for 10 years in jail. Trump tweeted Wednesday. Among those insisting that the trio be suspended for the entire season was Los Angeles Times columnist Bill Plask, who wrote Tuesday, if the three students had any sort of involvement in something so appallingly entitled and dumb while on a school trip to a foreign country, UCLA's next move should be clear. School authorities should say welcome home, and see you next season. The three Bruins were reportedly accused of stealing sunglasses from a Louis Vuitton store adjacent to the team's hotel where it was staying in Hangzhou, as part of a week-long trip that involved playing a game in Shanghai against Georgia Tech. Ball, Hill and Riley were released on bail in time for the game, but they were benched by coach Steve Alford. Now that they are back in Los Angeles, it remains to be seen when they will be allowed to play. During halftime of a nationally televised game Tuesday between No. 1 Duke and No. 2 Michigan State, ESPN's Jay Williams disagreed with fellow analyst Seth Greenberg's vehement assertion that the three players should sit out the season. Williams said they should be suspended for a couple of games, adding, "We're talking about kids." Greenberg exclaimed, "I don't care about kids. You're taking your team to another country, a different culture, they steal things in three different stores, allegedly. To me, that's egregious. They should not be able to play this year. This is an embarrassment," Greenberg went on. The arrest of the players coincided with the trip to Asia by Trump, who added an unexpected item to his agenda when he asked Chinese President Xi Jinping to help resolve their case. The basketball players, by the way, I know a lot of people are asking, I will tell you, when I heard about it 2 days ago, I had a great conversation with President Xi, Trump said Tuesday while aboard Air Force One in Manila. What they did was unfortunate. You know, you're talking about very long prison sentences. The Chinese do not play games. In his Wednesday tweet, Trump exaggerated the punishment the players were facing. According to a blog that specializes in decoding the Chinese criminal justice system, the players could have received prison sentences of anywhere between 1 and 4 years under the worst-case scenario, punishment that likely would have been mitigated by the players' ages and the fact that they appear to be cooperating with authorities. It's not clear what terms were negotiated to bring the players back, but it's apparent that they received relatively minimal punishments from China. Now it's up to UCLA, possibly with some input from the Pac-12 conference, to determine how the three freshmen should atone for what is a very embarrassing incident for the school. I want to be clear that we take seriously any violations of the law, UCLA Chancellor Jean Block said in a statement. In this particular case, Both athletics and the Office of Student Conduct will review this incident and guide any action with respect to the involved students. Such proceedings are confidential, which limits the specific information that can be shared. The 23rd-ranked Bruins have their home opener Wednesday, and before the game, Ball, Hill, and Riley, as well as Alford and Athletic Director Dan Guerrero, are set to offer comments on the episode but reportedly will not take questions. Tuesday evening saw the players making their way through a media scrum after landing at Los Angeles International Airport. Hanson Wang, a columnist for UCLA's student newspaper, The Daily Bruin, called Sunday for his school to lay down the hammer in disciplining the trio. Citing his grandfather's firsthand, frustrating experience with the Chinese legal system, Wang wrote that UCLA should suspend the three players for the entire year and possibly more. These players were responsible for representing UCLA in the country during their time abroad, and they failed to meet even the most basic standards of law-abiding citizens, Wang wrote. UCLA must hold them accountable and send the message that no player, or players, can be let off the hook for violating foreign laws and making a fool out of the school, the Pac-12 and the U.S. However, some have pointed out that UCLA officials might be concerned with how well lengthy suspensions may sit with LaVar Ball, Lee Angelo's father, who was with the Bruins in China when the arrests occurred and said of them, "It ain't that big of a deal." LaVar Ball's oldest son, Lonzo, starred for the Bruins last season before being drafted number 2 overall by the Los Angeles Lakers, and his highly touted youngest son, 16-year-old LaMelo, has already been ticketed to follow in his brother's footsteps and play for UCLA. UCLA officials now have the delicate task of determining a suitable punishment, wrote USA Today's Nancy Armour on Tuesday. And by suitable, I mean one that won't incur the wrath of Ball's father, LaVar, or prompt him to yank another son out of school. In waiting to announce its disciplinary measures for Ball, Hill, and Riley, UCLA might be trying to gauge how light a punishment it can get away with meeting out. However, anything less than a full season's suspension won't go over well with at least a few media figures. This is everything that's wrong with our great nation. People like this Ball tosser's father are given a platform to ooze their biased hate to the public. Why not instead ask him what he did wrong that his son was shoplifting, to begin with? Someone who speaks like this guy shouldn't even be asked questions by the media. Who cares what he says or thinks? We as a nation better start to wise up and put these people in their places. What exactly entitles this man to give his opinion on this international incident considering he wasn't even able to raise his son to know the difference between right and wrong?